Well, first of all, I think Johnson C. Smith has always been influential in that part of our city. And McCrory Heights developed because of Johnson C. Smith. It was the place where the faculty of Johnson C. Smith lived, ultimately, in the days when segregated communities were the norm. The Biddleville area itself was there in large part because of Johnson C. Smith University. More and more, there was a feeling that the campus itself was a kind of an oasis, and that whatever else was happening around it was just happening around it, but it wasn't good for the community. Or that the Smith people were so concerned about educating their graduates, like yourself, they weren't too concerned about the community. With President Carter, sorry, with Dr. Yancey, but with President Carter, really, I think, started to understand the themes of how important the university is to a neighborhood, to the development of the neighborhood. And their responsibility was more than just making sure that you had a good college experience, but making sure that the community itself around it was, in fact, thriving and doing very well. And so it's come outside of the gate now to embrace all kinds of issues, from transportation, working to spearhead the streetcar that's going to run up through Bates Ford Road one day, to the housing that it's building along the corridor in Mosaic Village, and that's just the beginning, to restoration of old houses that were occupied by professors that used to teach there a long time ago, to engagement in the community itself to let them know that the university is a resource, to trying to deal with issues, what we call urban issues. It wants to be the urban university, which is to say it wants to take the scholarship that's going on the campus and apply it to how the community itself could be better in terms of minority businesses, in terms of early childhood education, in terms of being involved with Project Lift and other kinds of programs that are occurring there. So it's taking the appropriate leadership role that I think it should be taking. And this is crazy, isn't it? But as it gets to do that well, it becomes attractive not only to African-Americans who live in that corridor, but to others who will filter into it, just as the university will start to take a more of an interesting identity with a more diverse population.